Hi, I'm Flora, and I'm here at Open Data Day in Seattle. And it's a Code for Seattle event, an unconference around open data and civic technology. I'm going to show you around and see what's going on.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Seattle Open Data Day. So we got people to submit stuff in the half hour after this. Each of your tables, or form small groups, and you are going to talk about what you would like to get out of today. And out of that, you will come up with more ideas, because this is not enough sessions yet to fill out the whole day. Then on each table, there are purple dots. You will use these purple dots to mark interest in the sessions. And at that point, we will put the sessions into this great butcher paper that Shelley has provided us, and that will determine when and where they happen. So that's the basic plan. It will be a group-generated schedule for the day. So as we get through these next presentations, you can be thinking about what you would like to be talking about today, because this is really meant to be interesting to you.
Hi, my name is John Kreese, and I led a session today on King County Open Data. The title was Compared to What? We had a great discussion about the user licenses at King County and how they differ from what you can do with data from the federal government. And I think we came away with an approach to go to King County and saying, hey, we'd like to use data in a more open way.
My name is Bethan Cantrell, and I led a session earlier today on how and why we would want to build privacy into apps and why we would want to think about privacy before we start designing our app. The reason that I'm here today is I think that open data and citizens' access to government data is important. I think it's important for civic engagement, and I think it's important for us to just feel like we're part of the community that we're living in. So I'd like to support it, and thank you.
So I'm Will Saunders, and we just got out of the Conversations with Government About Data breakout. I work for the state CIO, CEGWA, and I think the top two takeaways for our team from our little breakout session were, number one, a lot of interest in something called collective action, and a set of principles for, and a kind of a taxonomy for social action outside of government. We were predominantly folks working in government and some folks from outside of government interested in working with government. And we were all very interested in that collective action set of principles. The second big takeaway was the importance of getting sort of first-tier community action agencies and prime contractors to talk about, advocate, and expect two-way communication with government about data and with data. That there's a qualitatively different discussion that happens when existing business partners and existing advocacy organizations that are successful in talking to government make this an agenda item on their informal conversations with government. So we'd like to see that sort of first ring of action agencies and prime contractors make data a key element of their conversations with government.
I'm Candace Faber. I'm the project manager for Hack the Commute.
I'm Zach Shanner, do outreach and marketing for Commute Seattle.
I'm Brian DePlace with Seattle Department of Transportation.
And our session today was called Everything You Need to Know About Transportation to Build a Killer App. It's a preview of what we're going to be talking about, both the data sets and the problem sets for Hack the Commute, which takes place March 20th through 22nd.
And a lot of expectation setting in this session. What is out there, what is not out there, what's possible, what's not possible. I'm sort of laying the lay of the land when it comes to transit data. Anything
else? S-Dot's excited to be here.
S-Dot's very excited to be here, finding good tools to improve how we're navigating around the city.
So I'm Shelley Farnham. I am with Third Place Technologies. I organized two sessions today, actually. The first one was on alternative sources of open data that are more around nature. So a lot of the open data movement has really been focused more on urban data, like crime data, you know, transportation, that sort of a thing. And I thought, well, actually there's a lot of really interesting data out there that's really about more about nature. And that went really well. It was largely a conversation around what are the resources, what are best practices, what are some things that we should all be thinking about. It does sound like in the sort of forest services and fish and wildlife departments, they have the public data, but they really haven't engaged with the open data movement in the sense of putting it into these public repositories like Socrata. So that was good to have that conversation. The second one was social media, thinking about social media as open data, that you can actually, there's actually a lot of resources out there where you can access social media as public data and integrate it into your applications like Twitter and Instagram, Facebook, Yelp. And so we just talked about what are some examples of that, you know, why use social media, what are some really interesting or compelling stories that you can get from combining social media data with open data. And then talking also about sort of some of the privacy and identity concerns about using social media data.
I'm Ryan Villava, a policy advisor with the Mayor's Office of Policy and Innovation here in Seattle. I'm with you today partially to talk about what the city wants to do with data, which is to use it much more often, not only in its decision making, but also getting data out there for civic hackers and others to make apps and help people use data better. I also talked about a couple projects that the city has recently debuted. One is Performance Seattle, which is using data on departments' performance to talk about how well government is carrying out its mission. And the second is Open Budget, which is a more user-friendly, interactive website to share budget data. Both of these, we think, really represent sort of a first step in getting to a better place on how we share data and use it to make decisions. So very excited to be here today.
My name is Meg Young. I am from the UW Tech Policy Lab, and I wanted to come to the Open Data Day to talk to people about privacy and re-identification of open data sets. Often when the city decides to release data, it is going to be scrubbed of some of the attributes that people would find to be personally identifiable information. But with a correlation attack, different data sets can be put back together and people can be re-identified. So we wanted to talk about how people think about that risk, to what extent it's a problem, and different levers we might have to approach that situation.
Hey, I'm Seth Vincent, one of the co-organizers of Code for Seattle, and I'm here to learn. We've held a bunch of hackathons at Code for Seattle, but I really like the opportunity to talk and learn from people that are smarter than I am about a lot of these things, so attending sessions and just seeing what kind of conversations take place.
I'm Chris McCormick, and I'm here to meet new people and learn about projects where I can apply my skills and give back to the community.
Hi, I'm Bruce Blood. I'm the Open Data Manager for the City of Seattle, and I'm here at Open Data Day, and it's been a great event so far. I led a session on the City of Seattle's performance metrics application that we just launched on Tuesday last. It's called Performance Seattle. Look it up, Performance Seattle, performance.seattle.gov. And big event coming up on March 20th is Hack the Commute. And we'd really like to see everybody involved.
Hi, my name is Sarah Schott, and I'm working on a book on open government called Civic Spark. And I led a session called Facepalm, Challenges of Working Between Civic Tech and Government. So we had a pretty well-attended session and a lot of conversation around strategies and common challenges we were facing in working with government. My favorite part of it was doing the spectrogram, where participants got to see, as they lined up on a kind of spectrogram of experience, where their opinions differentiated on making government more open or more modern with technology and how their backgrounds influenced their opinion.
Hi, I'm Chris Metcalf. I'm the developer evangelist from Socrata, one of the sponsors of the event. I'm here to help the people who meant get access to and use Socrata and government data via APIs, and I led a session earlier today on getting started using the SOGA APIs.
Oh, I'm Alan Meekins. I came out to Open Data Day to find out what kind of data the city of Seattle is curating and producing, and to see how entrepreneurs and other interested parties can be involved.
Hi, I'm Andrew, and I came out today because I'm trying to get involved in the civic hacking scene in Seattle, and I wanted to learn more about the open data sets that were available and just talk to people and see what other people's ideas are and help move things along.
I'm Michael Patrick. I'm a geospatial analyst. In other words, I deal with geographic information systems. And our session was called OCD, Obsessive Compulsive Data. But really what it is about was not open data, was about metadata, the context where all of this data lives. Who, how, why, when, and where the data was produced from workflows, who the customers are, that enables to actually understand what the data is. So we had a broad number of people from industry suppliers, somebody that worked for metadata for the federal government, and a lot of broad spectrum input on the problem. We came to the conclusion that it's like eating right. Everybody knows you should do it, but very few people do it.
Hey, my name is Darshan. I'm a creative data analyst, and I'm at Open Data Seattle to collaborate with my peers and figure out how we can use open data for positive social change.
Hi, my name is Will Scott. I'm one of the co-captains of Code for Seattle, which is the local chapter of Code for America. And we are helping to organize Seattle Open Data Day this year, which is an unconference. So what does that mean? We're having a bunch of discussions around the intersection between technology and civic issues. And we've got a bunch of different topics there that are, I think, spawning a bunch of really interesting discussions, and that we're getting stakeholders together to talk about these things and figure out, you know, what the problems are, what needs to get built, and continue down these paths that lead to the projects and lead to the ways to make things better. So there's a whole set of discussions around the privacy implications. There's another set of discussions around the APIs and what hackathons can and can't do, and how we have productive interactions between these two groups and what the right language is to actually get the things done that you want to. Because I think this is still new for both sides, figuring out what is coming out of these events and what makes this effective. So I think we're having a really positive set of conversations. I think people are really engaged this year, which is exciting. And I think it's only going to get bigger and better as we go forward.